As part of the welcome, we also have various organizations that helped in helping here. And this is important that I welcome all and everyone and enjoy the occasion over here. Thank you.
Your own game plan to overcome these new techniques of minimally invasive spine surgery. No technique is bad. You have to choose your own technique. Another thing is for the seniors or the faculty like us. We'll have to take care that we don't have to exploit the technique. Every technique is very good. Every technique has its own advantages and disadvantages. But don't try to exploit the technique. It will defame the technique. And we have to survive in this competitive field. And the third thing what will help us in surviving this minimally invasive spine techniques is the economics. We'll have to see that the end result, the patients are satisfied and the economics, we should be able to provide the results with a very good economic, it should be very good, it should be economic for the patient. Otherwise, due to the newer technologies, if the treatment cost is going to be too much for the patient, then this will these techniques will be for only for the elite, very few surgeons, and it will fade away in the future. So we have to take care of all these things so that this MISI and the techniques will survive for a long time and then with the help of the newer technologies. And welcome you all for the MISI 2017, and thank you.
Actually, I stopped doing spine surgery almost about 12-15 years back. And suddenly when I came to this particular hall, I find my teachers, my mentors, my friends, so many of them whom I was able to identify and sort of associate with them. Just to mention a few, in 2 hours, 2.5 hours. And I could remember the Sundays they used to call me for the scoliosis assistance, which used to go on for 6 hours. So that is the tenacity that is required for the spine surgeon. I know the minimally invasive might now have reduced quite a lot of time. Professor Rangaswamy, a great mentor with whom I worked as an assistant professor at Sri Ramachandra, and later when he came back as a vice chancellor, I had the occasion to work as a dean of education and help in educational matters. Professor Rahul Dutt, I haven't operated with him, but I have been associated with YSS, the South Zone Orthopedic Association, and I know the contribution that he has done towards spine surgery, and it's nice to know that recently he is leading the Spine Surgeons Association. Dr. Rajamani from Madurai, another person with whom I had the occasion to work quite a bit, and he has this excellent capacity of putting forth his thoughts so very well. Nikhil from Apollo, I had the occasion to have, you know, sort of help him with some of the patients whom I referred, and Dr. Prashant Kekre, who used to visit Sri Ramachandra while he was a consultant there, and a lot many more. And Dr. Karthik Kailash, when he joined Ramachandra, we were instrumental in sort of getting him there. Very focused towards spine surgery. And he did not just leave it like, you know, just learning it. He was also an assistant with Professor Sri Ram. He went around, had training abroad, both in the UK and the US, came back, and we were a little, you know, sort of concerned when whether we should start the department, the division of spine surgery and the department of orthopedics. There was no doubt in Ramachandra that he should be the leader, but whether it was the right time for us to start this division was a worry for us. But we took the plunge, thanks to Professor Rangaswamy and Professor Marthandam for facilitating this. Today, he has taken it to such heights that he has developed a new innovation. I know minimally invasive surgery came in a big way in joint replacements. It was in vogue for about 2 or 3 years, then slowly it passed off, where people started talking, wounds heal from the size and not from the length. So that type of approach probably is not there towards minimally invasive spine surgery, because it's extensive. I've seen Professor Sridham exposing right from the skull up to the sacrum. Those days when we had to stabilize very horrendous deformities, not for no reason that it was done, where there was extensive deformity which had to be corrected, and we had to do something like that. So Karthik has come in a very big way, and he has sort of probably influenced the formation of an association for minimally invasive spine surgery, and we have leaders. And it was so awesome for me to sit through for 1 hour here to listen to presentations. Gone are the days when people used to come and give lectures for 20 minutes, 30 minutes. They were able to crisply put their thoughts in about 7 minutes and convey the real focus and what needs to be presented and the take-home message. So I think there is a lot of improvements towards that. And I'm happy that Karthik is probably going to also honor some of our teachers during this particular program. Highly thought out program. And this is spine surgery. I am told that we have probably performed the maximum number of such type of surgeries in this part of the world. And he's going to take forward in doing more and more of this. And I understand, because basically I'm an orthopedic surgeon, some of the things which I could not imagine are being done. This surgery probably is an illustration we learned through Professor Ranaswamy way back, long time back. But now I understand you can do PLIF, you can do TLIF, you can do spinal fusions of any length, you can do spinal instrumentation. So I think everything and everything can be done using this technique. And so a word of caution to the youngsters is, do not take up to newer areas without sufficient training and sufficient exposure. Even if you have to go abroad and get some training, or even in India there are any number of centers which give you that exposure, get access to this, and probably these are the days when you should probably do in a three-stage manner as an educational principle. First, try to do it on mannequins, then try to do on cadavers, and probably then try and do on human beings, first assisting experienced surgeons, and then go on to do yourself. And also, I was happy to see some of the speakers tell the word of caution that all indications do not suit all techniques. And we should probably aim to get the appropriate indication for the right patient and use the technique. That is our intelligence. Instrumentation today, the companies will tell you that anything can be done, and we should be carried away by that. The entire spine team under the leadership of Dr. Karthik Kailash, with the help of course of the senior leaders in the field, has really come forward to do this 3-day program. And I understand yesterday you had quite a lot of live demonstrations of many surgical procedures, and it was all relayed in an excellent form now. And the technology now allows you probably to even project this for many people to watch this from their home.
I urge you to always see the tip of your instruments, so it's a very safe undulation, and you follow your instruments in any direction.